We already have applied various arithmetic operations on the various primitive variables and constants. Now this is the time to compare them. This is the time to find relation between them. This is the time to find which one is greater than other, less than other, and which two are equal. Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the second session of Java and Wave, variables, data types and operators. In this video we will learn about relational operators in Java. Relational operators are binary operators which work on the primitive data types, either variables or constants, and return only Boolean data type. There are the following relational operators: less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, equal to, and not equal to. When we try to find the relation between two operands using a relational operator, the relational operator follows the following steps. If we are doing an operation as a less than b, first it promotes both the operands to maximum of integer type of a and type of b. Then compare them and finally returns the Boolean data type, either true or false. If we are writing a less than b, we say this statement as a less than b. If the a is quantitatively lesser than the b, then the operator returns true, otherwise the operator returns false. This operator works with all primitive types except Boolean. This operator does not work with string data type or other non-primitive data types. This is the program. Here we have integer variable a, integer variable b, both contains 5, and then we have a double variable c which contains 3.2. Now in this statement, we are comparing a and b. Here we are asking that is a is lesser than b. If yes, then this operation should return true. If no, then this operation should return false. You can see here a is 5 and b is 5. So both a and b are equal. A is not less than b. That's how this operation will return false. And false is going to be stored in the Boolean variable c1. Now check in this statement. We are again asking is a is less than c. A contains 5 and c contains 3.2. Here the integer 5 is quantitatively greater than the double variable c. So this operation also results false. Means 5 is not lesser than 3.2. That's how this operation results false. And that false value going to be stored in the Boolean variable c2. Look at this statement. Is c is lesser than a? C is the double variable which contains 3.2 and a is an integer variable which contains 5. C means 3.2 is quantitatively lesser than the 5. That's how this operation results true. And that Boolean true is going to be stored in the Boolean variable c3. So the Boolean variable c1 contains the Boolean value false, c2 contains false, and c3 contains true. That's what we print in last three lines. Let's compile and execute this program. Vi relational.java. This is the same program we just discussed. Compile and execute it. Java C relational.java. Compiles fine and then run it Java class name relational. It runs fine, printing false, false, and true. Then we have other operator called greater than operator. Here the closed mouth of the operator is at right hand side and the open mouth of the operator is at left hand side. If the operand at left hand side means A is quantitatively greater than the operand at right hand side means B, then it returns true, otherwise it returns false. This operator also works with all primitive types except Boolean. This operator does not work with string data type or with other non-primitive data types. This is the same program we just discussed with the less than operator. Only difference is that here we are using the greater than operator. In this statement, we check if a means 5 is quantitatively greater than the b means 5. The answer is no. A and b are equal. That's why this operator will result Boolean false. And that Boolean false is going to be restored in the Boolean variable c1. In the next line, we check if a is greater than c or not. If 5 is greater than 3.2 or not. The answer is yes. That's how this operator returns true, and that true is going to be stored in the Boolean variable c2. Here we check if c is greater than a or not, if 3.2 is greater than 5 or not, the answer is false, and that Boolean false is going to be stored in the Boolean variable c3. In next three line, we are printing the c1, c2 and c3, which prints false, true and false. This is a task for you to apply greater than operation practically in a Java program. This operator is called greater than equal to operator. If we are applying the greater than equal to operator on the two operands, then it follows following rules. If a is greater than or equal to b, it returns true, otherwise it returns false. It works with all primitive types except Boolean, does not work with string or any other non-primitive data types. Here we are applying the greater than equal to operator in a program. Here the integer variables a and b contains 5 and the double variable c contains 3.2. Now look at this operation. A is greater than equal to b. Here we check if a is greater than or equal to b. That means we check if 5 is greater than or equal to 5. Here 5 is not greater than 5, but the 5 is equal to 5. That's how this operation results Boolean true. and that boolean true is going to be stored in the boolean variable c1. Here we will check if a is greater than or equal to c. That means if 5 is either greater than or equal to 3.2. The answer is yes, 5 is greater than 3.2. That's how this operation results the boolean true. And that boolean true is going to be stored in the boolean variable c2. In the third line we check, is c is greater than or equal to a? Is 3.2 is either greater than or equal to 5? In this case, the 3.2 neither greater than nor equal to 5. That's how this operator will result the boolean false, and that boolean false is going to be stored in the boolean variable c3. Finally, we print c1, c2 and c3 and it results true, true and false. Again, this is a task for you to apply greater than equal to operator in a Java program practically. This one is called less than equal to operator. Suppose that we are applying the less than equal to operator on operands A and B. If the operand A is less than or equal to operand B, the operator returns true, otherwise the operator returns false. The less than equal to operator works with all primitive types except Boolean. And the less than equal to operator does not work with string or any other non-primitive data types. This is the program where we are applying the less than equal to operator. Integer variable a and b contains 5 and the double variable c contains 3.2. In this statement, we are checking if a is less than or equal to b. That means we are checking that if 5 is either less than or equal to 5. The 5 is not less than 5, but the 5 is equal to 5. That's how this operator returns boolean true, and that boolean true is going to be stored in the boolean variable c1. In the second line, we are comparing if a is less than or equal to c, means if 5 is either less than or equal to 3.2. The answer is 5 is neither less than nor equal to 3.2. That's how this operator returns boolean false, and that boolean false is going to be stored in the boolean variable c2. In the third statement, we are checking if c is less than or equal to a. That means if 3.2 is either less than or equal to 5. 3.2 is not equal to 5, but the 3.2 is less than 5. That's how this operator returns boolean true here, and that boolean true is going to be stored in the boolean variable c3. Finally, we are printing the boolean variables c1, c2 and c3, which prints true, false and true. This is a task for you to apply less than equal to operator practically in a Java program. Then we have equal to operator. Equal to operator denoted by double equal sign. Remember that if we are writing a equal to b, only one equal sign between a and b, then actually we are assigning the value of b in the value of a. But if we are writing two equal signs between a and b, a is double equal to b, that means we are comparing if a is equal to b or not. So if you are applying the equal to operator or double equal operator to the operands a and b, then it returns true if a and b are equal. Otherwise, it returns false if a and b are not equal. So if a is equal to b, it returns true, otherwise it returns false. This operator works with all primitive types, including Boolean. Remember that the previous four operators, less than, greater than, less than, equal to, greater than, equal to, do not work with Boolean data types. But equal to operator works with Boolean data types. The equal to operator works with the string and other non-primitive data type in a special manner. We will see it in the different sessions of the Java and Web. In this program, we are applying the equal to operator. We have integer variables a and b storing 5 in them, and then we have the double variable c which contains 3.2 in it. In this line we are checking either a is equal to b or not, either 5 is equal to 5 or not. The answer is yes, that's how this operator returns boolean true, and that boolean true is going to be stored in the boolean variable c1. In this line we are checking if a is equal to c or not, if 5 is equal to 3.2 or not. The answer is no. That's how this operator returns the boolean false, and that boolean false is going to be stored in the boolean variable c2. In this line we are checking if c is equal to a or not. That means if 3.2 is equal to 5 or not. The answer is no. And that's how this operator returns boolean false, and that boolean false is going to be stored in the boolean variable c3. Finally, we print c1, c2 and c3, which prints as true, false and false. Let me apply the equal to operator in a Java program. Vi relational.java double equal a double equals b, a double equals b, then write here a double equals c, and write here c double equals a. Compile and execute it. Java c relational.java, compiles fine and then run it. Java relational, it runs fine, printing true, false and false. But be aware of one thing: if you write here a single equal b instead of a double equal b, then it becomes something different. Let me compile it and see what the compiler is saying. Compiler says incompatible types int cannot be converted to Boolean. Here actually you are trying to assign the whatever is stored by the B in the variable A. And then after you are trying to assign the whatever is stored in the A to the variable C1. So single equal operator means assignment, and a double equal operator means you are checking if the both operands are equal or not. Then we have not equal to operator. Here we are applying the not equal to operators to the operands A and B. If the A is not equal to B, then the operator returns true, otherwise the operator returns false. The not equal to operator works with all primitive data types, including Boolean. The not equal to operator works with the string and other non-primitive data types in a special manner. We will see it in the different sessions of Java and Web named string and wrapper classes. In this program, we are using the not equal to operator. Here we are checking if A is not equal to B. That means if 5 is not equal to 5, the answer is no. That's how this operator returns Boolean false. And that Boolean false is going to be stored in the Boolean variable C1. In this line, we are checking if A is not equal to C. That means if 5 is not equal to 3.2. That's how this operator returns Boolean true, and that Boolean true is going to be stored in the Boolean variable C2. Here we are checking if C is not equal to A. The answer is yes. That's how this operator returns Boolean true, and that Boolean true is going to be stored in the Boolean variable C3. Finally, we print C1, C2 and C3, and that prints false, true and true. This is a task for you to apply not equal to operator practically in a Java program. In this program, we have a 16-bit character variable A, which contains Unicode of capital A, that is 65. And we have the 64-bit double variable B, which contains 3.2 in it. In this statement, we are comparing either A is greater than or equal to B. That means Unicode of capital A, that is 65, is greater than or equal to 3.2. The answer is yes. That's how this operator returns Boolean true, and that Boolean true is going to be stored in the Boolean variable C. And finally, we print the Boolean variable C, which prints true. This is a task for you to type and run this program. In this program, we have the Boolean variables A and B. A contains true and B contains false. As we noted, we cannot apply less than equal to, and greater than equal to operators on the Boolean data type. That's how this line returns an error, bad operand, and the program does not compile. In this program, we have two Boolean variables A and B. A contains true and B contains false. In this statement, we are checking if A is equal to B or not. We know that we can apply equal to operator and not equal to operator with Boolean data types also. So it checks if A is equal to B or not. We can see here A is not equal to B. A is true but B is false. That's how this operator returns Boolean false, and that Boolean false is going to be stored in the Boolean variable C. Here we are printing the Boolean variable C, which prints false. In this statement, we are checking if A is not equal to B or not. Since A is true and B is false, that's how A is not equal to B. And so this operator returns Boolean true, and that Boolean true is going to be stored in the Boolean variable C. Finally, we are printing the Boolean variable C, which prints true. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video, subscribe this channel if you are new, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next.